हम है जिद्दी, मच्छरना समझना, हम है मक्खी, खून हम आपका चूसेंगे, बात समझ लो पक्की, मैट और लिक्विड डेटर हमारा कुछ बिगाड़ ना पाते, असर करने से पहले ही हम आपको काट खाते, इसी से तो होता है हमारा गुजारा, पेट भर खाता है हमारा कौम सारा। देख जिद्दी मच्छर मेरे हाथ में है क्या, गुड नाइट का इलेक्ट्रिक जेल नया, 110 गुना ज्यादा इसमें है शक्ति, इसका मतलब मच्छरों से पूरी तरह मुक्ति, गुड नाइट इलेक्ट्रिक जेल, अब 110 गुना ज्यादा असरदार।
नमस्कार, गुड इवनिंग, आई होप सब ठीक है, अच्छे से हैं एंड सेफ हैं, स्पेशली पीपल इन वेस्ट बंगाल एंड उड़ीसा, आई होप थिंग्स आर लिटिल बिट बेटर। ऑल्सो होप दैट, बहुत मैंडेटरी चीज है, मैं बोलता रहता हूँ बट ये इम्पोर्टेंट है, आई होप सब सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग मेंटेन कर रहे हैं, हो सके तो घर पे हैं और एक दूसरे का ख्याल रख रहे हैं। ओके, सो टॉकिंग अबाउट 11 on 10, आई वॉन्टेड टू एंड दिस सीरीज 11 on 10 विद अ बैंग, एंड माई गेस्ट टू नाइट ऑन द शो इज नथिंग शॉर्ट ऑफ अ फायर क्रैकर। ही इज लाउड, ही इज सुप्रीमली टैलेंटेड, बट आई एम नॉट श्योर इफ अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल, अ लॉट ऑफ हिज फैंस नो दिस, दैट बिहाइंड ऑल दोज ब्राइट क्लोदिंग, न्यूमरस अवार्ड्स and crazy energy is a very simple guy who can't help but keep it straight. Copywriting's loss became acting's gain, and I'm going to hurry to get superstar Ranveer Singh with us. I know all the fans can't wait.
Oh, captain, my captain!
How are you doing, Ranveer?
Happy to be.
Can you hear me?
Bas hamara saath de de.
नहीं नहीं कोई नहीं, साथ देगा इंटरनेट, दोस्त डोंट वरी। कैसे हैं आप?
गुड, फीलिंग गुड यार। संडे का दिन है, लॉकडाउन के बीचों बीच हैड अ गुड वर्कआउट, स्पेंड सम टाइम विद द वाइफ, गॉट सम वर्क डन, एंड दिस इज द हाईलाइट ऑफ माय डे, डेयर आई से द हाईलाइट ऑफ माय मंथ और पास्ट 2 months, आई हैव बीन हाइबरनेटिंग, एंड दिस इज लिटरली द फर्स्ट टाइम I am a part of any kind of public broadcast, but when the skip calls, you must answer the call.
Thank you so much. Really kind. And I must say, so whenever we announced our guests, there are a lot of questions that come from people, which we also read. Although 10 questions are mine. Sorry, guys. But then a lot of them said that, no, he hasn't come. He doesn't come live. We don't know much about him. And I wanted to ask you why. Is it a conscious thing or you were just zoned out and in your own space?
Captain, I've been engaging with this period of lockdown in many different ways. In the first 2 weeks, it felt like something. Then in the first month, then month and a half. Now it's been 2 months. So I've been going through different phases. First, just, trying to wrap my head around everything that's going on in the world. Every time you wake up in the morning and you open the news and you read what is happening, and it's a very grim scenario. And it's disturbing. It's actually devastating to witness what is happening in this unprecedented pandemic to all our brothers and sisters, not just in our country, but across the world. You know what the world is facing, this global crisis that is really, it weighs down on you, you know. So True. I was going through my own process of, wrapping my head around it in a way, you know, it has an effect on you emotionally, mentally. I don't think I was prepared to engage anything or anyone in public, you know, just staying home and making sure that, I'm using this time in as positive a way as possible, you know, trying to be positive, trying to be optimistic, trying to find the silver lining, trying to see the brighter side of things. As grim a scenario as it is. So I also use this time to kind of hibernate and experience the joy of doing nothing. There's a charm to that as well. True. I must say, before this, it was life was moving at a very frenetic pace, a very hectic pace. I felt like I was a hamster on a wheel, you know, in the middle of the rat race, especially after Padmavat, then Simba and Gully Boy. My workload in the past year and a half increased to a level where I was teetering on the edge of sort of like a burnout kind of feeling. In a way, this lockdown period has been well timed for me. I get this time to introspect, to focus on myself. You know, as actors, you know, they say you are the player and you are the instrument. This body that we have, this mortal vessel that we have, we are the players and this is our instrument. So to be able to focus on myself, to be able to get time with my wife after we got married, the year following our marriage was busy for the both of us. So it's given us time to rediscover each other in a different way, bond with each other. I honestly didn't feel like being out there. I said mauka mila hai to might as well be in hibernation and go underground. I enjoyed that period of being under the radar, off the grid, as they say.
Oh, that's nice. But if I can request you, from all your fans, keep enjoying what you're doing, but just give a little bit of glimpse of what you're doing, a picture maybe, or what you're doing in a day, because the message that we have got, me and my search team, man, just throw a picture, let us know what you're doing, tell us if you're singing, stuff like that. So just for your fans, request from them, and I'm forwarding to you. Whenever you can, just throw a little bit here and there for them to be happy.
I will most definitely. Point great. Noted, well taken, and registered. Great. Thank you for conveying, Captain.
No problem. So let's start.
Yes, sir.
See, I am a 90s kid.
Yeah.
And I say it all the time, and I know you also a 90s kid.
Yeah.
What are things that you remember from 90s? and one thing I particularly want to ask is, when I used to watch all the serials and stuff then, yeah, probably was different from yours because you saw it from a different mind. You know, I saw a lot of places where you interacted people, you impersonate people, you were totally into that. So were your experiences watching all those Dekh Bhai Dekh, Zawan Sawal Ke, all the stuff different than ours? Or was it the same, like just have fun?
I most very rightly said, Skipper, I'm a 90s kid. You know, it's the born in 85, that 90s era is the one that defines you. You know, you follow everything from films to music to fashion to pop culture. And those are your formative years. Those are your foundation years. So whatever you consume and register and subscribe to in that period, it stays with you forever. So I have the fondest memories of everything that you mentioned. Dekh Bhai Dekh. Zaban Sambhal Ke. I used to basically, na Captain, I used to be a TV ka bachcha, a product of television, a TV kid. When kids sitting outside, I was sitting in front of the idiot box and becoming an idiot. If I was not watching movies on VCR, I was watching Doordarshan. I was watching
VCR. Yeah. Good one. Yeah. Kids don't know about VCR now.
I used to wait for Mahabharat on Sunday, Ramayan on Sunday. I used to wait for Chhayagit. It was like an event. Everything was worked backwards from the telecast time. Deepika has come and tuned into our chat. She's saying you are terrible at math.
That was so harsh. Terrible at math. Wifey doing wifey business.
Yeah, I was kind of terrible at math. I still am. I was never able to.
That makes two of us. That makes two of us.
Really? I think we turned out all right. So, all the kids out there who are facing this constant pressure of,
maths in general, well in mathematics, don't lose hope.
Yeah, it's not the end of the... It'll be great if you can do it. But if you can't do it, it's not the end of the world. You can tomorrow... If you find your passion, you can become Sunil Chhetri, even if you are not good in maths.
No, and you can become Ranveer Singh also, man.
So yeah.
I think I could. Captain, yeah, go on. Please go on.
That's the decade for me. I used to watch television non-stop. And especially in the early 90s when cable television came, I was just hooked. Like, I was watching WWF and even when my mom used to watch Bold and Beautiful and Santa Barbara and all, I used to be hooked watching the stuff that one really shouldn't be watching at that age, but that's all the kind of programming that we did get. Sure. And I'd wake up at 4 and 5 in the morning to watch, Star TV. There was Garfield and Small Wonder and all. I was just hooked. Even my idols were all the leading men from the 90s. It started off with Amitabh Bachchan and then Aamir Khan, Shah Rukh Khan.
Govinda,
Anil
Kapoor. Yeah, he was one of my favorites.
Salman Khan, all the big 90s heroes, Sunny Deol, Sanjay Dutt, Sunil Shetty, you name it. These guys were like my idols. Like, I wanted to grow up and be them. So my fascination for movies my obsession with television, it all started in the 90s, and those shows are the ones that you remember with great fondness. They're cult shows. Nowadays on Instagram you have these handles, with kind of social media you can exchange these memes and stuff. I get very excited when I get those memes about only a 90s kid knows,
will understand this. Exactly. And you have a smile on your face. Oh, this happened, this was there.
So what were your favorite shows? You used to watch Dekh Bhai Dekh and Zaban Sambhal Ke.
I know the song Zaban Samal Ke, Jaja Ho Kaho Par Zara Dekh Bhai Ke. I know all of this. A lot of places where I go, and when they talk to me, they think, he won't know these things. I was hooked. I love the fact you say WWF and not WWE. It was WWF.
Yeah.
Stone Cold Steve Austin completely was my favorite. And okay, I have to ask this: your first cable TV, was it bought or was it stolen? Because mine was stolen. I still remember. So what happened? My father was in army and he was away. So I told my mom, we need cable TV. She said no, for two reasons. One, you're going to be spoiled. And two, 180 bucks, forget it. Not on something that she doesn't think is good for us. So I got this tar, a whole wire. I went down with my friend and I hooked it. और वो अंकल ने मुझे पकड़ लिया, वो मेरे घर पहुंच गए, तुम्हारा बेटा और तुम्हारे सारे दोस्त,
देखो,
बिकॉज उनका फिर कनेक्शन लूज हो गया ना, उन्होंने खरीदा था तो उनका कनेक्शन लूज हो गया, तो वो हमारे घर आ गए. सो व्हाट वाज योर्स, वाज इट बॉट और वाज इट स्टोलन लाइक आज?
माइन वाज बॉट, एंड टू बी ऑनेस्ट आई वाज अलाउड टू, आई वाज सच अ मेनेस, आई वाज अ वेरी वेरी मिस्चीवियस किड. So they were like, at least when he sits in front of this idiot box, at least he's in one place not creating trouble. But I feel like, Deepika had a very different upbringing. She was an athlete growing up. So she used to not watch that much television. So sometimes she turns around and she asks me, how do you know all of these things? And you know so much about so much. And I'm almost embarrassed to admit to her that more than half of my knowledge comes from very random, unexpected sources like television. It's not like I read this in a book or something. Like the lead character in Patal Lok, he spews all this gyan, Jaydeep Alawar's character. He has a lot of gyan about Indian mythology, etc. But he says, lekin,
Hathiram.
Shastro mein likha hai, lekin maine WhatsApp pe padha hai. So basically, I have all of this useless, knowledge about various things, and I've got it all from watching television, and I have insights into cultures and stuff. It's only because I was a big TV buff, so I'm actually a product of television and 90s television, to be precise.
And watching those serials, did you ever think that you're going to be in one of them, or you're going to be an actor? Or was it just like having fun and you didn't know at that time that you wanted to be an actor?
Actually, it was when I used to watch these movies, which used to, the lead characters would be these larger than life characters, where I used to consume all the mainstream films. Like, my earliest heroes were Sylvester Stallone, Arnold Schwarzenegger,
Amitabh Bachchan
in his larger than life avatars. You know, it was those guys who used to, those characters and those individuals who used to fascinate me. So I used to be obsessed with Rambo when I was a kid.
We all were.
So I used to wake up in the morning and I used to take a lal rang ka patta and I used to stand in front of the mirror and I used to tie it like
look at your own self in the
And I had a big toy gun which I used to carry around all day, and if anybody would address me as Ranveer, I would be like, my name is Rambo, call me Rambo. So it used to, my obsession used to run so deep that I used to go to sleep with and just like Rambo, he used to tie a knife over here. I used to take a butter knife from the kitchen and tie it on my ankle and sleep. So I was very, very obsessed with these larger than life heroes. And my fascination with movies started there. I found this fan world to be very alluring, you know, where you can be something that you can be something fantastical, you know, something that's larger than life. So I was always attracted. I would not perhaps not be able to articulate it, but I was definitely attracted to the point of wanting to be a part of that world. You know, to be, मुझे basically, you know, हिंदी में बोलते हैं मुझे हीरो बनना था और मुझे बचपन से ही बनना था. मतलब as far back as I can remember, I didn't want to be anything else other than a हिंदी फिल्म का हीरो.
Wow, that's a good story. Look where you are now. That's a good story. So yeah, so to my next query, copywriting was always your first calling, isn't it?
Copywriting was actually my my backup, Captain. I thought about copywriting as an alternative to acting in case the acting gig didn't work out for me. Because, you know, when we were growing up in the 90s, there were only very few examples to go by where somebody from the outside had broken into the Hindi film business, you know. The way the Hindi film business was structured for the longest time, for lack of a better way to put it, it was like a mom and pop shop, you know. All the prime opportunities were reserved for people who kind of had a backing of lineage or of some kind. There were very, very few examples of guys, just less than a handful of guys who had made it from the outside. So it seemed like a very far-fetched thing for somebody like me to aspire to want to be in movies. It was around 10th standard where the question started becoming a little bit serious. Ki actually, aapko life, abhi aap 15 saal ke ho. Going forward, you're going to change your institution. You're going to junior college. You have to choose arts, commerce or science. And you have to kind of start planning what you're going to really do with your life. So I used to be very naive and think that it would be simple for me to become an actor. But at the age of 15, I looked around. It was around the year 2000 and I didn't really have any examples to go by. You know, I looked around and all the people who were, you know, making their debut in movies were all somehow connected to the film industry. You know, there was no case for me to hang on to and say, if this guy can do it, I can do it. So at the age of 15, I kind of abandoned that lifelong dream of mine to want to become an actor. I said, yaar, ye apne bas ki baat nahi hai. This is a bit far-fetched. Ye it's out of my reach. So at 15, I thought, what else is it that I enjoy doing? I used to enjoy writing these one-liners for ads. Mujhe yaad hai, school mein na, ek competition rakha tha. Aur वो कंपटीशन में आपको एक प्रोडक्ट देंगे और आपको उसका पूरा एड जिंगल लिख के देना है और मैं उस कंपटीशन में फर्स्ट आया. तो मुझे लगा यार ये काफी कूल था, करते हुए बड़ा मजा आया.
क्या बेचा आपने और क्या लिखा आपने, इफ यू रिमेम्बर?
स्कूल वो वाले कंपटीशन में पता नहीं, लेकिन इट वाज लाइक अ डोमिनेंट विक्ट्री. मतलब मैंने फाड़ दिया था कॉम्पिटिशन में. फिर बाद में अंकल से बात करके पता चला कि दिस इज समथिंग यू कैन एक्चुअली डू फॉर अ लिविंग. ऐसे कुछ लोग हैं इस दुनिया में जिनका whose profession is copywriting, जिनका काम यही है कि प्रोडक्ट के लिए एक लाइन लिखें, उसके उसके अराउंड एक स्टोरी बनाए, मार्केटिंग स्टोरी बनाए. So I said, this is great. This is another career option for me. So I really thought that I was going to become a copywriter. I joined media studies and I was on track to become a copywriter. But at the age of about 19, it kind of hit me that this is not my real love. This is me making a compromise. This is me settling for something less than what it is I actually want deep down in my heart. And I'm glad that I had that realization. I expressed it to my father and he was immediately supportive. He said, beta, just do what's in your heart. Only then you're going to be good at what you do. And that's how I was able to pursue becoming an actor. Varna to main copywriter banta tha. Halaki, maine 15 aur 19 ke beech mein do internships kiye the. Ek ONM Mumbai mein aur ek JW
Mumbai mein. That's why I asked you, yeah.
And I had good feedback in those internships. From what I could gather, I could have been a good copywriter. I was a very bright intern and I could have totally become a copywriter. I remember ek rap, us waqt mein bhi main rap mein hi likhta tha. और वो एजेंसी में ना मुझे दे यूज्ड टू कॉल मी द राइम स्पेशलिस्ट दे वर लाइक इफ यू हैव अ लाइन एंड यू नीड अ राइम विद इट जस्ट गो टू दिस गाय इज लाइक द राइम डॉक्टर ही कैन राइम एनीथिंग विद एनीथिंग तो ऑल माय सीनियर्स यूज्ड टू कम एंड यूज्ड टू से जस्ट सी इफ यू कैन राइम समथिंग विद दिस एक वो मच्छर मारने की वो का वो प्रोडक्ट होता था ना गुड नाइट हाँ तो गुड नाइट जेडब्ल्यू टी में हमारा क्लाइंट होता था गुड नाइट और गुड नाइट के लिए मैंने एक रेडियो जिंगल लिखा था और वो दैट द क्लाइंट एक्चुअली लव्ड इट दे एक्चुअली बॉट इट वो क्या होता था ना हमारे सीनियर्स जो थे ना दे यूज्ड टू बी वेरी हंग्री फॉर अवार्ड्स तो दे यूज्ड टू राइट ऑल दी सेरिब्रल एड्स दैट वुड गो टू कांस एंड स्टफ एंड हैव अ चांस ऑफ विनिंग अवार्ड्स अब हमारे बस की बात नहीं थी टू राइट दी सेरिब्रल टाइप्स ऑफ एड्स सो हम बड़े लो ब्राउ एड्स लिखते थे जैसे lines for good night used to be like coil tha hara par machhar nahi mara le aaiye lal aur dekhiye kamal so these to aam bhasha mein jo likha jata tha wo client ko bada pasand aata tha so I used to sell more ads as an intern than my seniors who were writing cerebral ads so clearly I had a future as a lowbrow output kind of copywriter aur ek rap bhi likha tha mujhe yaad hai I had given it the title Machhar Rap.
Go on, please.
Kya tha yaar? Ha. Ding 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 Machhar Rap. Yo 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 Machhar Rap. Yo yo. हम है जिद्दी मच्छर ना समझना हमें मक्खी खून हम आपका चूसेंगे बात समझ लो पक्की मैट और लिक्विडेटर हमारा कुछ बिगाड़ ना पाते असर करने से पहले ही हम आपको काट खाते इसी से तो होता है हमारा गुजारा पेट भर खाता है हमारा कौम सारा देख जिद्दी मच्छर मेरे हाथ में है क्या गुड नाइट का इलेक्ट्रिक जेल नया 110 गुना ज्यादा इसमें है शक्ति इसका मतलब मच्छरों से पूरी तरह मुक्ति गुड नाइट इलेक्ट्रिक जेल अब 110 गुना ज्यादा असरदार
So this is my foremost Ranveer's product and his brain. Please do not copy it. Whoever is listening to this, कल को ऐसा ना हो कि हम ad देख रहे हैं और ये छाप दिया उन्होंने.
Good night वालों को in good faith मेरी ये भेंट है. आप इसका एक radio jingle बना के डाल दे तो मेरी writing साकार हो जाएगी.
So I have got to know that it's not only just the rap and the rhyme bit, but you write also. Not just copywriting, but you write also. And I know it's very personal and you probably wouldn't want to share, but is it something that came along the way? Do you still do it? Do you get time to write stuff, which is not just about rhyme and fun or copywriting, but something from your heart?
Skip, I actually don't write as such, but I contribute a lot in dialogue writing. That's something I don't think many people know, but this kind of side skill of mine comes very in handy when I'm approaching a character or doing a scene. Oftentimes what happens is when the writer is writing a scene, he's not in the space, he's not in the moment, he's writing wherever he's writing, in the confines of his home or his office or wherever he writes. And sometimes there are certain things that you need in the scene that are not there on paper. So if you have this knack of adding to the dialogue, tweaking the dialogue a little bit, it really comes in handy. It really like brings the scene together. Sometimes you need a link. So sometimes there are two dialogues which you feel are two different thoughts. So in order to have a bridge or a link between them, you got to come up with something. So this side skill of writing, that's where I find the most amount of use for it is when I'm contributing towards the dialogues in certain scenes. I joke with my directors that I want a dialogue writer credit. But really, I've been very fortunate to work with people who are open to that kind of collaboration. You know, the writers, the directors, they are always inviting this kind of input. And it goes a long way. It really makes the scene feel complete.
So talking about your skills as a copywriter, helping the directors with some added dialogues, your acting, your rap, there's one more talent of yours which overshadows all these talents. And before you say no, I've done a lot of research, so you can't even deny. And that ability of yours is to sleep. Now, before you answer this, there were many ways how people have tried to help you. One, your sister is getting chocolates to bribe you to get up in the morning. One, a very controversial one was you're doing a movie called Gunde and your co-star and friend and people from the team have said that there was a special person with Ranveer to stop him from going to the van to take a nap because you never know when he's going to come back. So all these allegations that are on you, please explain.
Skip, I have to admit, my sleeping habits are not the best in the world. I'm not very proud of them. My wife, my beautiful wife, my very helpful wife, is trying to help me in this process of sorting out my sleeping habits and getting some sort of streamlining and discipline into it. But my sleeping habits are terrible. I'll tell you why, Captain, because I am a creature of the night. I am a nocturnal creature. I have this great connection with the night time. I don't know what it is about the night that I find very attractive, you know, when the world is sleeping and there is thodi shanti hai, you know, you really have time and space and quietude to kind of be with yourself and with your thoughts. So I enjoy being awake at night, but that only means that I sleep very late, and that's where the domino effect starts. You sleep late, then you wake up late, then you're trying to take naps during the day to sustain your energy. So it's only because I love the night so much. And you know, in films often we have night shoots. To 2 baje ke baad sabki batti bujh jati hai. Main 6-7 baje subah tak main full power chal raha hu. और मैं सेट पे सबकी फिरकी भी लेता हूँ. कोई होता ना तो जो 3-3:30 बजे वो जिसकी जो झपकी मार रहा होता है, ए, 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 सुस्ती मत फैलाओ इधर, चलो. So I'm really good with night shoots, and I keep asking my co-actors, you good with night shoots? I love night shoots. So yeah, it's because I'm a creature of the night that early mornings don't really agree with me.
So bribe from sisters has been transferred to bribe from wife, or wife doesn't need the chocolates? She has some other ways to get you up.
Sister has extra affection for me, so she'll try the bribe route. My wife will be there with a balan in the morning.
And with a great forehand. So don't underestimate that. She's a great forehand also. So yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And but she's not insensitive like that. I've told her, baby, in the morning, I'm very vulnerable and I'm very like sensitive. So thoda halka haath rakh ke uthana mujhe. She's very kind that way.
Okay. So that leads me to the fourth question, Ranveer, and this is an acting question. And before I ask you, I want to apologize because I don't know much about acting. So if I do ask something which is stupid, just pardon me. Okay? So, the movies that I've watched yours, the last four ones, Ram Leela, Padmavat, Gully Boy, and which is the fourth one that I watched? Again, Sanjay Leela Bhansali one. So, all these four movies...
Bajirao Mastani.
All these four movies, what I see is you're so passionate and deep into the role. Okay? And I also done the research where I've known about stuff, how you go about a role. And I know for a fact, it's very passionate, very deep, a lot of hard work. Does that also mean that if something doesn't go your way or people don't like it, the sadness and sorrow is twice? Because, you know, why I'm asking this? Because your profession, you work for months and months and it all goes to one Friday. It's not very fair, but so much of hard work put by so many people, it goes to one Friday. So are you somebody who broods a lot after something if it doesn't go away, or you just like, you know what, I did it and I move on? What kind of person are you?
That's a great question, Skipper. I had to hit the ground running when I started working in show business, in the sense that I didn't realize how the thing works. Jaise ki aapne bahut rightly kaha, Friday to Friday hamari kismat badalti rehti hai. Like you said, you work for many months and then on a Friday, Saturday, Sunday, that the fate of all that effort that so many people, so many good people with good intentions have put towards it, it suddenly didn't click or didn't work with the audience, you know. I used to not know how to deal with it effectively in my initial years, but over a period of time, I evolved as a person. I got a little bit mature, if I may say so myself, in dealing with these things. And after a point, I realized the greatest gift is the process, is to actually be on the film set acting. And I had this realization. And around the same time, it was articulated for me by a speaker in a motivational speaker in an audiobook. Kya hua tha? 2015, I think, 14, 15. I had a very serious injury on Bajirao Mastani and I was really down in the dump, Skip. Like, it really had a devastating effect on me, you know.
Physical injury.
I had torn the labrum in my right shoulder and we had all the action yet to shoot. And it was a very, very big film for me at the time, a defining film for me at the time. And I was really crushed because I had trained very hard for the sword fighting. And before anything could be shot, I'd, you know, done this to my shoulder, unfortunately. So I started listening to these audiobooks of this motivational speaker who articulated it for me. And it said a very beautiful thing. The process is the prize, you know. If you realize that if you don't base your happiness, your joy, your fulfillment on the result, you got to shift that focus from the result and being result oriented to the process, and realize that the real reward, the real prize and the real joy is the process itself. Just being an actor, doing what I love to do for a living, being able to go to a film set and acting, being in front of the camera, living those moments between action and cut, collaborating with fellow artists who enrich your own craft, collaborating with filmmakers who shape you and mold you as an artist. This is the real reward. You know, just the act of, just the fact that I get to do it is the reward itself. So for me, if a film does well, it's a bonus. Sone pe suhaga. The fact that I got to work on it, I've already got my prize. I've already got my reward. So if it does well, that's a bonus. I've also learned how to more effectively deal with success and failure, in the sense that I was doing a little bit of reading, and I know that there is in Buddhism, they encourage you to adopt a middle path. And in the context of success and failure, they say if you manage to not get too carried away with success.
True.
And you manage to not get too bogged down by failure. Yeah. That's a much healthier way to be. So I kind of applied that in my life. So if a film is a success, it's almost as if I breathe a sigh of relief. Chalo yaar, bach gaye. Especially if you take into consideration the fact that such a small fraction of films actually are successful. you know, less than 10% of films are successful. The success rate of major motion pictures is very, very slim. So if a film is a success, you feel very happy for a few days, but then it's very transient. The feeling is very transient. You feel that joy for 3 days, 4 days maybe, and then your focus shifts back to what you're doing in the moment, you know. आप शायद किताबी या philosophical बात लगेगी, लेकिन I believe that the past is ashes and the future is wood. The only thing that burns is the now. तो अभी क्या हो रहा है इस वक्त, present moment में क्या हो रहा है? Present moment में भैया कल सुबह मुझे जाना है, जो फिल्म अगली मेरी आ रही है जिसपे मैं काम कर रहा हूँ, I have to go there, go get into character that morning and do my best on that day of shoot. And all my energies are focused towards what's happening in the now. So the success is the joy that you get out of a successful film for me is short-lived. And similarly, the failure, मातम नहीं मनाता हूँ, I don't mourn the it for too many days. बहुत बुरा लगता है, because you see, you share this one commonality with everybody who works on film, is that everybody who's working in film invariably is very passionate about films, is very passionate about, that's why they're there, from the light man to the spot boy to the cameraman to the director, everybody's very passionate about creating cinema. And when all these good people with good intentions put their best foot forward and all these collective energies come together to create this thing that is so beloved to you, you know, it's almost like a child. And then it doesn't do well, you feel very bad for the fact that it didn't work out. Then you get into analytical mode, what might have gone wrong. But very soon you have to shed that off, because that can be
detrimental.
If you engage with it in for a limited amount of time, it'll teach you something. You'll understand why people are criticizing, why it didn't work, what went wrong, what you could have done better. It'll teach you something, but you must engage then only for a limited period of time. After a few days, you got to move on and focus everything on what you're doing in that moment.
Yeah, why I ask you this, because a movie is made in months. Whatever the outcome is, it stays until you deliver the next one. It's so different for us. It's every week. Right. So you are a hero today. They're chanting your name. Next, they're abusing you. In 4 days, 5 days. Yeah. Again, you are a hero. So we don't have time. So we don't have time to think. There is no time. Oh, yaar, ye ho gaya. Wo mujhe ye bol raha tha. Usne mujhe kandhe pe le liya. Usne mujhe gaali di. No time. So the learning part for us is very quick. Saturday match, Sunday recovery. Monday, you got on the pitch. Bored. Go back. Saturday match again. That's why I asked you. And I also asked you because someone very close to you, I won't say scared, but is a little bit skeptical as to what will happen, because the last 4-5 movies of yours were a blockbuster. And last 4-5 movies, she saw you giving more of you to the movie. Now, she's a little bit wary. I won't say scared, but she, not the actress, but the wife, is a little bit wary what will happen, because every movie he's giving more and more. What will happen? And I hope the streak goes long. But it's life. You will have hits and you will have flops. As simple as that. But I hope the streak goes long. And I hope whenever it shouldn't come, but whenever it comes, be sane, because your wife is a little bit tense about it.
She's dare I say, a much more evolved person than I am. She's much more mature than I am. She has seen more ups and downs in her career than I have. And she's a great guide for me. She's a pillar for me. She keeps me on track. I often say that I probably wouldn't have been able to achieve the little that I have achieved in my career if it wasn't for her. I've been working, this is my 10th year, and I met her 3 years into show business, and I've been with her ever since. मुझे कभी कभी लगता है with I would not have been able to cope with the pressures of celebrity or cope with the status as a movie star, मैं भटक जाता basically. कहने का मतलब ये है कि अगर ये नहीं होती मेरी लाइफ में तो मैं भटक जाता. And she worries for me only on account of the fact that she sees you know that I'll go to any extent to achieve the desired result.
Exactly what she said.
I can't say it is it's very healthy at times. It does take its toll on you. There are certain characters who've taken it their toll on me physically, other characters that have taken their toll on me mentally, emotionally, but when you push yourself to the brink and you come through it, then you've evolved, you know, then you've progressed, you've pushed past the pain and the struggle, and then when you come out on the other side, you are a new version of yourself. And I think that's the beauty of the craft. But over a period of time, and I'm happy to report this to you and to my wife, who I'm sure is tuned in right now, that I have found more effective ways of achieving the desired result without those processes being harmful to oneself. So I'm becoming more adept at my craft.
Lovely. So that takes me to my fifth question, which is also about acting. And this is the last one. Again, disclaimer, if the question is naive, forgive me. So in my profession, it's a team game. Oh yeah, I saw. Yeah. Yeah, Mrs. is enjoying it. Yeah.
I love
so, it. Yeah. The only request, Deepika ji, please don't spill the beans. You gave away my question of the writer one. Please don't give away anything now, because I have got questions left to ask Ranveer. All right. So my next one is, we got a team sport, and I want to think even making a movie is a team sport where everyone comes together and builds something. So in my sport, even if you don't like what the coach wants, even if you don't like your teammate, doesn't happen often, but even if you don't like the ideology or anything, you still go with what the coach wants, period. You might not like it. You might not be happy, but you go with it, because in our sports, the probability of getting success is more if good or bad, wrong or right, you're in the same direction. How does it work in an acting thing? Because now I've also read, correct me if I'm wrong, that heroes have a lot of say on the movie. Again, I don't know much. So do you have those heated conversations with the director or the mind of the movie saying, this is not going right, let's do this? Or is it at the end, he says whatever and it's done. We all go to the same thing.
पहले तो मैं ये बोलना चाहूंगा, Skip, that these are not amateur level questions. आप जो the parallels you are drawing, they are very...
No, because I'm taking context from my own
story. No, it's a great question, Skip, and I would love to answer it. I think you're very right in drawing that parallel between team sports and the collaborative nature of movie making. It is a team effort. And the director is like the coach, like the manager. And like you very rightly said, you may not agree at times, but different players react differently. Some will rebel, some will do their own thing. I hear from you that more often than not, you have to go with the conviction of the coach, even if you're not in agreement. I would say the same thing as a leading man in the film, because I genuinely believe that films are a director's medium. You know, it's like you are just a tool. You are one part of a much larger process. But the actual creator is the captain of the ship, is the one at the helm, is the director. So you give your input to the director, present your point of view, but if you reach a point of conflict where what the director wants is not what you have in mind, there is always merit in going with the director's conviction, because he's the one who has his eyes on the bigger picture, and it's really his baby, it's a director's medium. So I find that in these sorts of situations, you should always go with the conviction of the director.
And has it ever happened?
But like you said, you're very. This is one insight that is absolutely genuine. Is that in the Hindi movie making process, like you said, the heroes have a lot of say. You know, they sort of.
I read about it. That's why I asked you.
They're very important centers of the movie making ecosystem. But that is evolving and that is changing. There is a new wave of artists, you know, who don't subscribe to the old notions of you know, the hero being the be all and end all or the authoritative figure on the film set. It's really, there's only one boss on that set and that's the director. So I'm very happy to report to you that the new wave has a very different way of acting in functioning in the filmmaking process, but yeah, you have to understand that you are a team player, and it's the director's medium. So you basically have to be cognizant of what your place is in this entire process and embrace that. And it's not like I ever shy away from giving my input or suggestion or collaboration. But oftentimes the directors love it. They love the suggestion. But if they reject it, you just take it in your stride and realize that the director knows best. And I will name the director with whom this holds absolutely true. Is a big boss, my main man, Mr. Rohit Shetty. I have a suggestion, I have something to contribute every time. Every time I'll go to the monitor and say, boss, main ye karu, boss, main wo karu. When he says it, he loves it, go do it, be happy. But when he doesn't do it, it is for a particular reason. And then when you watch the movie back, you're like, now I understand why that suggestion wouldn't work. So you have to realize that he's the one who has the bird's eye view and has a has his eyes on the final picture and the
bigger picture. Yeah. Same coach. So
his process is very precise. So it holds true in that case more than others. I understand that as the leading man, you have a position of leadership. You are a leader on a film set, and you have that responsibility. And I really am very thankful, but I don't have delusions about my importance on a film set. I realize that I'm only a part of a much larger process where there are a lot of other forces contributing to create this.
That's well put up. So I think a lot of sports people who have tuned in, that's a good insight in movies. Because I, as I said, I was asking you just as a fan, a lot of things that I don't know about movie making. So before I go to my sixth one on the rapid fire, can I request you for a small tea break, if you don't mind?
Totally.
Because I'm enjoying it. I just didn't realize it's 1 hour already. So to everyone who is tuned in, exact 2 minutes. And when I say 2 minutes, it means a sports person 2 minutes, not a movie making 2 minutes, which means 10 minutes. So in 2 minutes, we'll be back.